sigurno nije jedan od najmodernijih hotela ovde u Dohi. Ovde se nalazimo u Kataru za veliki forum Doha 2019. godine. Ogromne su mere sigurnosti, bezbednost, međutim ne osjeća se to. Doha Forum 2019. održava se svake godine. Međutim, on nikada nije bio tako obiman i nije imao toliko delegata iz velikog broja zemalja. Ovde u hotelu Sheraton, koji je stariji negde oko 50 godina, sigurno da ima mnogo, mnogo lepših i vrednijih građevina. Međutim, vladar Katara, Emir, odlučio se nekako sentimentalno i tradicionalno da kad god dođe neki gost, zvaničnik, da uvek odseda u ovom hotelu i ovde održava sve svoje diplomatske aktivnosti. Saznajem da je ovaj hotel jako tako star, upravo skoro renoviran, tako da je počeo da dobija na neki način sav taj glamur koji karakteriše čitavu ovu zemlju. Znate što je zanimljivo? Zanimljivo je to da njihovo bogatstvo ne dolazi samo od gasa i od nafte, jer znaju oni da to nije večito. 50 godina postoje rezerve, a šta će biti posle? Znate šta rade? Pošto su izuzetno bogati, oni investiraju. I to investiraju u strane firme koje dolaze ovde, daju im šansu da razviju svoj posao i nadaju se da njihova dobit će u svakom slučaju doprineti procvatu ove zemlje, da ostanu i dalje bogati, jer kažu da su najbogatiji u čitavoj ovoj regiji.
Forum je otvorio šejk Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani. Bio je pozdravljen od 3000 učesnika gromkim aplauzom. Mahathir Muhammad, sadašnji premijer Kraljevine Malezije, koji je bio pozvan nakon što je već 15 godina u penziji preuzeo vlast u Maleziji, bio je stvarno u centru pažnje. Takav čovek svojim iskustvom, a ima 94 godine, govorio je o budućnosti i privukao pažnju svih prisutnih. Katar je u svom kratkom veku imao dve velike tragedije. Početkom 20. veka španski grip je pokosio veliki broj ljudi, a uragan 1925. u jednom satu usmrtio je 8000 ljudi sa ovih prostora. Potopljena je tada većina brodova koji je Katar tada imao i bio poznat po proizvodnji prirodnih bisera koji su imali zapaženo mesto u ekonomiji Katara tada. 1929. godine došao je slom berze i bilo je manje zahteva za biserima, a pored toga je i Japanac Mikimoto započeo proizvodnju veštačkih bisera. 50. godina počinje eksploatacija nafte. 1976. pronađeno je i najveće izvorište prirodnog gasa u svetu.
My name is Abdullah. I'm working in an oil company here in Qatar, oil and gas company, international oil and gas company.
And you?
Yes, my name is Mohammed. I'm as well in the oil and gas field in Qatar.
Tell me, I heard that there is a lot of fuel in this country, but the fuel is not going to last more than 50 years. So you are running even a business to look forward in the future. And I heard that there is a lot of investments.
Okay, the first part, I don't think so I can answer. I'm not a specialist to answer your question. But yes, there is a lot of investment here in Qatar. Qatar is developing, is improving. And as you see today, we have Doha Forum, which around more than 2,000 delegates, I heard, are coming here. So there will be a lot of agreements, a lot of investment here today and tomorrow. So which is normal, Qatar as a rich country, so they will invest a lot, either internally or externally.
Tell me, for you in Qatar, what does it mean to be rich? For example, I'm coming from a country which is not rich. For you to be rich, what does it mean exactly?
So we have resources. We have natural resources, we have human resources, and as you know, we have a Qatar National Vision, which is 2030, and one of the pillars is the human. So Qatar is investing in human, and rich is not only the money. as well, you know, you have the education, you have the infrastructure. So I believe Qatar is one of the richest country in the world, and they have very good resources. And as you know, His Highness Sheikh Tamim, he's making everyone here to feel comfortable, and he's doing a lot for us.
Are you married?
Yes.
Tell me something, for example, how you live, what's your wife,
etc. Okay, I'm married, I have four kids. My wife as well, she's working in the government, and my kids are in the school now, they are studying, and we have a life same as any Qatari here in Qatar. We have very good life, we have very good social life. That's all.
You have only one wife?
Yes.
But you can have two.
Yes, you can have two, but you know, there is rules and regulation. There is not rules. You have to have your cause why you need the second wife. So for me, I'm comfortable with my wife, so no need to have a second wife.
Ono što je primećeno na Doha forumu, to je sve veće prisustvo žena. One su na neki način ne samo prisutne kao posetioci ili kao supruge onih koji govore, već i samostalno nastupaju. Među njima ima jako mnogo profesionalaca, uopšte ima i naše koleginice koje rade ovaj posao. To dokazuje određenu vrstu sve prisutnijeg otvaranja. Nekako je veća otvorenost nego što je bila ranije.
I'm here to look at the role of women in the Afghan peace process, the role of women throughout Afghanistan, and so I'm very pleased that we're able to use the Doha Forum as a platform to advance women's rights.
Do you see any changes from the point of view that they can make the same as a man today?
I think my personal view is that women absolutely can do the same things as men. In fact, we can be better than men in many areas, so I'm not worried about that at all. But in order for women to accomplish great things, they have to be given the right platform. They have to be given the opportunity, first freedoms, and then the chance to expand and really go for the maximum that their talents will allow them to do. That's what I want to do for women everywhere around the world, including in Serbia.
We have a lot of women in Egypt, from Egypt in jails now.
Now?
Yeah. Mothers, sons, daughters, and we have, I think, so recently, 19 years old girl in jail because of her father. So they punish girls for their father's opinions or for their opinions in themselves. That's it in Egypt.
Do you think you can change that?
We are trying to by making our voice louder, we're trying to do this.
I am here to attend some sessions that I'm interested in, to broaden my horizon and to understand the world better.
Abaya and Sheila and Abaya. It is it's more a region dress in our Islamic. So it's not necessarily to all of women dress the same, but sometimes like they should cover their body. So it should not be tiny, it should not be skinny, it should be in white and like it's like my dress.
Some women are completely covered, right?
Yeah.
Whose decision is that she covers herself or not?
It's their decision, actually. I decide what should I wear.
Are you married?
I'm not.
When you get married, for example, is your husband going to interfere the way you are going to get dressed?
Actually, no. As I said, it depends on our decision. How would like I to wear? How would like I to choose my colors? Anything. think it's my decision. It's not my husband, father, brother, no. It's all depends on what I would like to wear.
Do you think that women in Doha are very, very free, completely open?
Actually, it's not. I can't say it's open or they are close-minded. Every woman in Qatar, they are educated, they have the knowledge, they have everything, they are well-known about everything. So what's the meaning of open-minded, do you want to know? It depends on you. What is the open-minded? Open-minded for me, it's about education. So all women in Qatar, they are educated. They have all knowledge about everything.
Ivanka Trump je privukla veliku pažnju ovdje na forumu u Dohi. Samim tim što je specijalni savjetnik svoga oca, američkog predsjednika Trumpa, istakla je da pokušava sve da u određene zakone poboljša uopšte stanje u poslovanju kod žena. I sama je preduzetnik i sva svoja iskustva primenila je na svoj uticaj i na svoj consulting kada govori o američkom predsjedniku Donaldu Trumpu.
You should know you are beautiful.
That's
this is the thing you should know.
That's
it is very nice of meeting.
You made my day.
To je veoma zanimljivo da se ovdje okupljaju na multilateralnom planu mnogi koji bilateralno nemaju baš najbolje odnose.
Sve se pomešalo nekako.
Tako da, evo, u isto vrijeme možete da vidite i znate da Katar ima dosta problema sa svojim susjedima. S druge strane, Katar veoma često ima veoma dobre odnose, veoma pokazuje se, a i samo prisustvo Ivanke Trumpa ovdje pokazuje da ima izvanredne odnose sa Sjedinjenim Američkim Državama. S druge strane, premijer Malezije koji je ovdje bio glavni gost nije se baš pohvalno izrazio o potezima Sjedinjenih Američkih Država. Tako da sve u svemu ovo jeste jedan multilateralni skup i mislim da je Kataru veoma bitno da oni imaju jednu tradiciju održavanja ovakvog skupa i da je time pokazuju da su deo jednog modernog sveta.
Kada pomislite da Katar postoji jedva 50 godina, ne možete da se ne zadivite takvim napretkom. Neverovatna dostignuća, ostajete zadivljeni onim što vidite. Suočeni ste činjenicom da ovi ljudi vole i cene svoju zemlju i to iskazuju na svakom koraku. Zakoni su vrlo strogi. Vladar Katara je šeik Hamad bin Khalifa Al Thani, čija je dinastija uspela da ujedini u 19. veku suprotstavljena plemena. To je čovjek koji vas gleda sa svih strana, sa velikih panoa. Njegove slike nalaze svuda, o njemu se govori sa strahopoštovanjem kao ocem nacije, da je njegova porodica zapravo stvorila državu Katar. To se osjeća na svakom koraku. Katarom vlada porodica Al Thani i veliki broj onih koji su zaposleni u državnoj službi potiču iz tih porodica. Oni su odgovorni vladaru, glavi porodice. Često se može čuti da Katarci ne rade sve poslove. Oni rade uglavnom u državnoj administraciji, a za one druge grublje poslove i one koji oni neće da rade, zapošljavaju strance.
What they are asking you about this you are responsible for, you know, it's a human rights. What human rights is in your country? What is your biggest problem? What they ask you to correct, for example?
There are, as you know, there are maybe 90% from the population from the migrant workers. For that, the migrant workers, there are very important challenge facing them. For that, really, we work with our government. We give our government and we work with them to find solution to challenge the migrant workers' rights. Thank
you. Are you going to fight for it?
we achieve some things from this, but still there are challenges, and we try and we work with the international mechanism to work to improve this in the ground.
We are in very complicated world nowadays, and this world every day it's become more complicated. And I think without having a diplomatic and a politician solution, we cannot solve the thing. So what is the best way to solve any kind of problem in the human, with the human being? It is the open dialogue.
And to talk. And
to understand each other and to try to have a win-win situation. No need to have, you are only the one who will win, but it is better to, how can we, even in the United Nations, I am as special advisor for the United, the SG of the Secretary General of the United Nations, we're always looking how can we have a win-win situation.
Al Thani, Emir of Qatar, heads of state, heads of government, ministers, excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and dear friends.
When you talk about Qatar and everything what is happening here, what is your message, in fact? Because I saw you, everybody did.
You know, I don't know if I have a particular message. I used to be based here in Doha as a as an anchor for Al Jazeera English. I'm now based in Washington, D.C. I travel the world, moderating different events and really meeting different people. So just being in Doha once again, in a place, in a part of the world that is so buzzing with energy, that is also rife with neighboring tensions, I think it's a message that we are all here, we're all diverse, and we have lots to bring to the table. And I suppose that's the only reason why I'm here, just to do my bit.
The thing is that this Doha Forum is trying, and probably is going to be very successful, to just to lose up the tensions, you know, this is how I feel it.
I mean, the Doha Forum is doing its bit. I mean, this is its 19th edition, so it's been going on for quite a while. And I think increasingly, I haven't been to each forum. I was here last year moderating a session. But I think every year you get a feeling that there's more attendance, in a way more solidarity because of the situation that Qatar finds itself in with the blockade. So I think all of these tensions are there, the big elephant in the room and all of those issues that are in the back of one's mind, specifically with the topic that is the overarching theme this year, reimagining governance in a multipolar world. I think that hits on a lot of different nails.
Drago mi je da sam vas upoznala ovde, stvarno. Veliko mi je zadovoljstvo na ovakvom mestu i toliko daleko od naše zemlje. Lepo je vidjeti naše ljude ovde.
Koliko dugo ste ovde i kako se dogodilo da ste došli u Dohu?
Ovde sam 3 godina, tako da, eto, sasvim slučajno. Htjela sam da spoznam neka nova iskustva, da saznam nešto više o naciji, o Kataru i nisam se pokajala zbog toga.
Kada ste dolazili, jeste zamišljali da je Doha ovakva?
Nisam. Iskreno, imala sam totalnu viziju, totalno drugu viziju ove zemlje. Nekako sam mislila da su oni mnogo zatvoreni, da nisu ljubazni, da će jednostavno biti odbojni prema svim ljudima koji dolaze ovde. Nasuprot tome, zemlja je totalno drugačija i sve ove građevine i sve što su oni izgradili, to stvarno izgleda impozantno i ovo treba doživeti jednostavno, tako da ja preporučujem svima da dođu i da nas posete ovde, sigurno. Sad, za našu zemlju je vrlo lako, još su i vize otvorene, tako da mislim da bi svako trebao da nas poseti ovde.
Kojim poslom se tačno bavite?
Radim u hotelijerstvu, tako da zadužena sam za jedan restoran, tako da gostoprimstvo, naše srpsko gostoprimstvo je došlo u Katar.
Da li dolaze vaši iz Niša da vas vide, ili neko dolazio?
Pa, dolazila je moja porodica i sad dolaze ljudi sa juga baš dosta, pogotovo od kad su granice otvorene, dosta naših turista dolazi ovde i hoće da upozna Dohu. I ja im se uvek nađem da im ono pomognem, da im kažem, da ih usmerim šta treba videti ovde, tako da zadovoljni su.
Šta bi meni rekli da vidim obavezno?
Kad bi morali da izaberete jednu stvar, šta bi rekli?
Stari grad, stari duh u Dohe. To je nešto što sigurno trebate videti i doživeti, jer tu je ipak njihova tradicija, nešto što su oni bili pre nego da se sve ovo izgradilo, pre nego da su pronašli to što su pronašli, pre nego da su uopšte dostigli svu tu moć koju imaju sad u današnjici, tako da stari grad je nešto što sigurno preporučujem, jer će tu osetiti onu njihovu toplinu, gostoprimstvo.
Ovakve ljude koji sa metlom idu svuda po gradu vidite često. Toliko je čisto za neverovati. Jedan papirić, jedna trunčica ne može da padne, a da on to ne vidi i ne pokupi. Evo, na stari način, bez nekih posebnih mašina i aparata, ovaj čovek pravi neku garderobu, verovatno za neko hladnije vreme nego što je sada. انت معلم واحنا منك نتعلم انت معلم واحنا منك نتعلم نسكت وانت موجود ما نرضى نتكلم 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 واللي خلاك ما يفهم يجي له يوم ويندم واللي خلاك ما يفهم يجي له يوم ويندم وما تسمع اللي يخدعك انت معلم وما تسمع اللي
زوم سراد ميلا لازيج živim u Podgorici, inače sam iz Mostara. Moja čerka radi već ovdje 7 godina u Qatar Airwaysu. To je njen suprug. Očekuju prinovu krajem godine. Dječaka i ja sam oduševljena. Imam još jednu čerku u Srbiji, živi unuku veliku i sama sam u Podgorici, pa sam došla ovdje na jedan duži period, u stvari na pola godine, koliko mogu da ostanem.
Pa došla sam iz Tunisa, sam radila u Tunisu, jednoj velikoj turističkoj agenciji i došla sam da radim za Qatar Airways. Tako da radim Qatar Airways u operativnom centru već 7 godina i ovo je moj suprug, on je inače iz Pakistana i lijepo mi je ovdje, lijepo je u Kataru, Katar je divna zemlja, evo uskoro nam je dan državnosti i svi se radujemo tome.
Hoćete se vraćati tamo kod nas?
Pa ne znam tačno gdje, da li u Srbiju, da li u Crnu Goru, da li u Bosnu i Hercegovinu. Za sada ne planiram, ali možda kasnije. Uvijek je lijepo doći, ali sad mi je ovdje dobro, pa možda za par godina. Vidjet ćemo posle fudbalskog prvenstva kako će se da bude ovdje. Pa...
Jel mislite da je to fudbalsko prvenstvo užasno važno?
Pa mislim da je važno jer kao prvo za Katar je jako bitno što odvija u Kataru, jer fudbalsko prvenstvo, koliko zemalja će učestvovati, jako je dobro za turizam. Tako da možda situacija u Kataru bude još bolja za turizam, jer možda bih ja i sad zavio kampanije i vratila se na svoje prvobitno zanimanje što je u turizmu. Pa ako tako bude, ja ću da ostanem dalje. Ako ne, možda planiram neku drugu državu, možda Evropu, možda kod nas opet. Tako da je to, zbog toga kažem. Ali svakako je odlična reklama za Katar to što su oni učesnici, odnosno domaćini takvog prvenstva.
Al Janu stadion, udaljen je od Dohe 25 km, delo je poznate Zahe Hadid. Njen projekat započet je 2016. godine, završen u maju 2019. Nije doživela da vidi završetak svog projekta. Posetioci na ovom stadionu neće osetiti vrućinu, jer air condition je ugrađen u čitav ovaj prostor. Stadion je u obliku bisera, koji asocira na barku ribara iz Al-Vakre, koji su nekada lovili bisere. U Dohu će za svetsko prvenstvo doći mnogo, mnogo ljudi, a Katarci željno očekuju, raširenih ruku, i kažu da žele da svi oni koji dođu naprave svoje lične utiske o tome kakva je ova zemlja i kakvi su ljudi.
Dve grupe navijača. Nema nikakvoga sukoba, samo navijanje, jer uskoro počinje fudbalska groznica.
Going. It's coming stay for a drink coffee because tomorrow I have a party for Esperanza Tunisia with Sad Qatari. I need to enjoy with my friend. All my friends make a ball for 3 days or 4 days for coming watching for football. Inshallah marbouha.
How important football is in your life?
It's in my heart. Esperanza, it's all in. It's all here. Maybe make 20,000 real Qatari for coming watching football here because the Esperanza here in my heart. I like Esperanza. Thank you very much.
Can you sing now for us? Ovo su navijači iz Tunisa koji su došli ovde u Katar, imaju utakmicu i navijaju za svoj klub.
Thank you.